So these are a pair of novelty speakers that I remember using in high school because I really liked the idea that they didn't need any power and they just plug right into your headphones. So they're basically headphones that everyone could actually hear. And what I figured out about them is they actually sound better upside down than right side up. Whenever you put them on a surface, and that's when I first learned about reflections and basically like corner loading and placement tuning. These things just need a soundboard really bad because they don't have like, you know, they're just basically just bare speakers inside of plastic boxes. But not bad for just headphone jacks, right? But here, let me just swap them back and forth. See how you can't really make out the melody? Now watch, let me switch back to these guys. So yeah, it was like the first time I learned about timing and how much timing really mattered as far as like how a speaker works, how a grand piano works, you know, where all like the thick strings are coalesced along the side where the hinge of the grand piano soundboard is, so it would actually, you know, work as a corner loading mechanism and time all the strings to sound like one giant instrument. And yeah, so just playing with these and how much difference that made, I just thought it was kind of neat. So I would always just play them upside down and play them in mono because I didn't really care. I just wanted, you know, them to be loud, and we were usually just out in the park or something, you know. I also got these guys. So those are pretty much like designed for corner loading or something. So they actually lock together in a mechanism. But yeah, they're just, I guess, outdated as copper wire. It's just cool that it happened to work as headphones that you could actually never run out, just put them on any time you wanted, and they fit inside your backpack. But then these have a little slot port, so you could also angle these upside down as well and test how it sounds. See? These just always sound better upside down. That's the funniest thing. They could have just sold them that way. They could have just turned the Sony logo upside down. And I don't know, that looks like a stand to me. But you're supposed to stand them like this and tilt them upward at you. But it's not like you could attach a subwoofer to them. So you could just, they are what they are. But yeah, you could do this, I guess, if you wanted to. But the best way I've always found these work is upside down, oddly enough. When that's just like not typically like the way that you would imagine you would actually have speakers, like you would imagine they would inspect these things and just kind of set them the way that it would be optimal, since it's just one speaker and one port, and the time alignment of the port and the speaker shouldn't actually be that big of a deal, being as you imagine the port should actually be a little bit behind the tweeter or mid-range.
God of the pen, light to myself, if when
See? It sounds like that's four. And it's not position, location. It's just how it is. Yeah, I like vintage stuff, and these are definitely sticking with me just as like cool little vintage gimmicks, but they're just pretty rad for what they are. These are a bit over. I like the way these are more compact. These are actually real legitimate ports. They just don't really do much. So I might end up doing something with this, modifying it with like some horn speakers, like some piezo horns or something, instead of like just a typical driver, and making them as loud as possible, and then just using like whatever low end I could possibly squeeze out of them. Yeah, but if you have a pair of these, just play them upside down and they sound better. And that might just be because that's the way PAs are when you're on, like, if you're ever a band geek or anything, you know how PAs work, and you just kind of angle them upward at you, and it just doesn't matter. Like, the way that they're set is geometrically so that you could place them in any orientation, and these are basically just set as you would a PA. Yeah, I just found it odd that they just, for some reason, just decided not to just do a simple test. I bet you it even sounds better if it was floor loaded, like with a soundboard, but like if they had something that would like pull out so it would actually like reflect off of it or something. But I don't care, it's not like it's a big deal. Yeah, so I'd be curious how they sound in stereo. Yeah. Rocking my high school, whenever the teacher leaves the room drunk, bump kit. A little MP3 Napster bumpsters. And yeah, I actually really liked them when they first came out, just because, like, you know, you could just plug them into your iPhone or whatever, and you'd actually, you know how the first iPhone didn't even have an external speaker? Like, you know, a lot of original MP3 players didn't have external speakers, so having these things just made all the difference. And then you could do things like put them inside cups, which made them even, like, more interesting. It didn't make the sound, like, any more accurate. I don't care about it. It wasn't a matter of accuracy, you know? It was just a matter of just getting them as loud as possible. Yeah, but anyway, thanks.